able to watch any more of the race on TV and being restless, James tries to cheer himself up doing what he loved best, watching a small car. He goes to Modena, home of Italian motorsport, to see the man. Meanwhile, for the racers, it's the long 500 miles back up to Brescia with some more stunning scenes to look forward to along the way. First stop, Siena. Siena is a wonderful world of medieval streets, medieval squares, monuments, cathedrals, and then out of nowhere, suddenly you come upon Piazza del Campo. For the pairback horse race, the Pannier, when the Mille Miglia is in town, it's the turn of the magic. Now, the home straight of Florence back up to Brescia. No one's sure who's winning, nearly always an Italian car with an Italian driver is the Italian Mille Miglia. Sam and Colin have got the bit between their teeth, and that's all. They're even skipping lunch and taking the home stretch very seriously. John and Jeremy also look like they're in a hurry. Is old Terry and Alan, although he hates the idea of being beaten by fellow actual woodchucks. Even a couple of hundred miles from the finish, other cars are falling apart like James is here, approaching the other car.
Both
now it's the home straight from Florence to Brescia. James is at the end ramp hours before any cars actually arrive back. Luckily, there are two distractions. James feels he has to make it up to Sarah for all the nightmarish pressure he's put her under and for not getting her to the finish.
This is the best dog shop in the world, but the world is expensive. This is a mind. You've got the power there, but you've got the power.
We've got